take the long way round. Oh, I'll find my own way down. Oh, as I should.
September 19th, paddling the west branch of the Penobscot. Did this trip last year, 2 years ago, with my father and my three children, and it was getting late in the season, so I thought that I would enjoy this river once again this year. It's pretty quiet. As you can hear my echo, I'm going to talk a little quieter. But this is a 3-night, 4-day trip. And it's going to take me down the upper west branch of the Penobscot. Going to camp one night on this river. Come out onto Chesuncook Lake, camp on Garrow Island, and then paddle south. And that's the trouble with Chesuncook Lake, is at least that we ran into a couple years ago, was that that lake can really kick up. And I'm hoping that the lake behaves this time. So looking forward to seeing some of the places we visited last time we were here, when I was with my family. A little sentimental value there, and just enjoying the peace and quiet. Moose. That's how high the water gets in the spring. Log jammed right into that bridge. On the Rose Island. This was once traveled by Henry David Thoreau a long, long time ago. Visited a couple times actually. This is part of the waterway that he traveled, as well as parts of the Allagash. So upper west branch of the Penobscot runs north, and so does the Allagash River. But anyway, Henry David Thoreau was absolutely in awe with the beauty that exists here. And he wrote about it. A lot of people these days will travel his same path, which it was done in a couple parts. Can't remember how many years separated his journeys. But there's Thoreau Island and a campsite, which is just a short part into the trip. Last year, we did the same trip, as I said earlier, with my three children and my father. By this point last year, we were all soaking wet. I mean, every inch of us was wet because it was raining the whole time. From the moment the boats were put in the water until we got to the campsite, everybody was cold. Got the fire started. Everybody's spirits started to change a bit. Actually, they improved a lot. So, looking at the forecast for the next 4 days, it's gonna be a little chilly at night. Not bad, about 50, maybe 48. But I'll tell you something, woke up this morning, it was 32 degrees. It was a little cold this morning. Made you wonder, made me recheck the forecast. Not that 32 isn't tolerable, you can do it, you just gotta prepare a little differently. It's cold at nighttime. So, I'm hoping back there about a mile or so where I saw that moose. Hope I got that on film. I think I surprised him as much as he surprised me. He didn't stick around long. I was hoping I could get a better shot. I hope. He's big. Big moose. So, one thing also, just going on recall from the last trip, was we had already seen a lot of eagles. I haven't seen one, not one sign of one. So just ducks and moose. So I'm not sure how I'm going to play out this trip yet. Pretty much think I have the whole river to myself. At the put-in, at Lobster Stream, on Lobster Trip Road, if you're looking at a Maine gazetteer, there's a sizable boat launch. And that serves for people with trailerable boats. And they usually head right into Lobster Lake. There's multiple campsites on Lobster Lake, and it's part of the Penobscot River Corridor. Area. So pretty desirable campsites there, but very accessible. The route I'm going, if you go down the river, well, yeah, you could. This is a slow moving river. You could paddle up, but it's shallow for a boat, so I think you have some day guys that may come up to areas that they know where to go. But it is shallow, not here, but and for the good portion of it is. So getting back to what it's kind of like a sentimental journey for me. Really enjoyed my trip with my children and my father. So maybe I'll go to the scene. Ooh, look at that. It's full of surprises. So I don't know if I'm going to go to the same campsites. It's basically what I'm getting at. Might be fun to do that. then again, it might be, explore new campsites, see what they have to offer, fishing opportunities and everything like that. So I don't know. This is a beautiful river.
Bundles of flowers away through the hours of cold. Winter shall howl at the walls, tearing down doors of time. Shelter as we go.
I am at the Pines. I already have the tent set up. Canoe's up on shore. Got a little picnic area here. Got plenty of wood here. Just gonna have a little fire. Gonna cook dinner. A little food prep area. I'm not gonna do that. Just rehydrating my food tonight. And I went and picked some birch. So I'll use my little twig stove too to make some coffee. So here I am on the river. Beautiful spot, ultimately. However, not at the spot that I wanted to be at. I kind of, like I mentioned earlier, for sentimental value, wanted to stay at the same site that I stayed with my children. But I've never seen so many people on a river after being told at the gate that there's no one on the river. I must have counted 20 canoes, all with motors, and they are fishing, salmon fishing. I don't even know how they get up and down this river, to be honest with you. But they're skilled enough to do that. But here I am. Wasn't sure I was gonna find this because I didn't have it on my map. I wasn't planning on this. So, I'm hungry now. I'm just gonna set up, finish setting up, emptying the canoe, get my bedding all set up so I don't have to worry about that. So what I have for dinner tonight is either, I have chicken, black beans, cumin, paprika, black pepper, all dehydrated at home, dry as a bone, boiling water right now to rehydrate either that, or I have chili and rice, chili, black beans, with rice, with again cumin, paprika, and some black pepper, and some saison goya, and then just regular pasta, penne pasta with sauce, also dehydrated. So I think I'm going to go with the chicken.
Hey, Moose.
Coming out onto Chesuncook Lake, this is not what I remember this lake to be. There's Katahdin off in the distance. Yeah, the last time we paddled this lake, 3-4 foot seas. This is a gorgeous day. I should be able to make it over there. Hopefully that campsite that I'd like to camp at is not occupied. If you were to continue on to the Allagash, you would head over there. So that's a big island right straight ahead. And that channel goes to Umbazooksis, which is a gateway to the Allagash up that way. Someday I may do that too. It's Garrow 2 campsite, which is Chesuncook. Looks to be available. It's gonna be cool. So here's the site. It's a tent pad. Fire pit. Right out on a point. That's where we're heading tomorrow, early. And so this is the eastern shore over here. I'm gonna head back across the lake and follow the western shore. Because I have a feeling we're gonna be getting northwesterly winds. I have to do a weather update.
Flowers away through the hours of cold. Winter shall howl at the walls, tearing down doors of time. Shelter as we go. Oh, for me only, scared of the lonely arms. Surface far below these birds. Maybe, just maybe, I'll come
Chesuncook Lake, getting ready to head out to my next campsite. No wind right now, that'll change obviously today, but the wind died right down last night. Heading that way. Can't even believe these conditions on Chesuncook Lake. This is day three, and stayed at Garrow Island last night. It is the landmass that you see in the back of me, all the way the end of the lake there. So I've paddled 6.5 miles this morning. Directly across from us is Red Brook campsite. That is where we stopped last year during the difficult conditions, and it was occupied by a family with a motorboat, but the lake was so rough that and it was dark, getting dark, that we needed a place to sleep. And well, he towed us to this western shore up here. We couldn't find Sandy Point campsite, so we made camp. All really making camp was just pitching a tent and having a few sandwiches each, and then going to sleep. The very next morning, well, firstly, that day the water was a boil. And when I say it was 4-foot seas. And today, I'm just paddling along here at a leisurely pace, taking a break when I want to. So the next morning after we camped at our makeshift campsite there, woke up the next morning. I woke up around 4 a.m. and the lake was like a mirror, glass, smooth as glass. So I woke everybody up. We were already a day behind. And I didn't have the Garmin Explorer or a way of communicating with my wife. So, that was weighing on me, because I know that she was worried. And when we got back to where our takeout was at Allagash Gateway Campground, my fears were realized when my wife was going to call a rescue party to come find us. Rightfully so, I guess. So on these trips, you always take into consideration weather. It can change on a moment's notice, as many of you who have tripped like this realize. But this is, it's a big lake, and it's a lot of paddle and a lot of strokes, but like I said, I'm just taking my breaks when I need them. So it's 17 miles long, and I'm cruising the western shore, and I'm gonna paddle about 12 miles today. Gonna try and find that sandy point. Haven't seen any wildlife today. I was rewarded at the morning after the first campsite, the pines. Jeez, Mama Moose walked about 30 yards right from where I was drinking my coffee. Quite impressive. Day one, big guy. I don't think I got that on camera. Tried. I haven't really looked to see if I captured that, but this day here, pretty quiet in terms of wildlife. I haven't seen any deer, which I expected on the shoreline here. No moose, no eagles even. Just man versus lake today. That's it. So I added some extra paddling to my trip today. Thought that I had forgotten something back at the Garrow campsite, Garrow Island 2. I got back there and I didn't forget anything. So I wasted a little bit of time there and energy, but whatever. Good old day. I don't like making mistakes like that, but I also don't like leaving things behind, and I couldn't find it. So when I did get back there, I unloaded everything and finally found what I was looking for. Okay, that's it for now. I'll get back to you when I find Sandy Point campsite. Sandy Point campsite. Hence the Sandy Point. Right across from the Katahdin.